You can see the medical personnel in a stretcher, and we have no idea who it is, if it's a player, if it's a security person. I mean, we're not going to speculate at all. I have no idea, but this is obviously a very, very serious situation.
Medical personnel from the Anaheim Ducks made their way down from the stands, the trainers there. It's certainly one of the Blues players. These are just moments you don't prepare for. And
again, this happened during our TV timeout, and we have no idea who it is. And so, Darren, we saw the player taken off on the stretcher, and times like this, you just say a prayer. And here is the last sequence before the break, Darren.
Yes.
And this is all we saw.
Well, obviously, you see at that point the veteran defenseman going down, and everybody on the bench absolutely just startled, absolutely calling the trainers. Ray Burilli was to my left, and you could see the urgency of the matter and the look in the players' faces. And Ryan Getzlaff in front of me is with talking with Colton Parayko and Ryan O'Reilly.
So, Darren, it did appear it was Bouwmeester who went down there, and the players are all going to the locker room. And the second we get any information, we will certainly pass it along. Just a very, very scary situation here at Honda Center in Anaheim. But, Darren, as we know, there are doctors at every game, medical personnel, emergency personnel, and he will get the very best care possible. And we just say a prayer at this point. I suspect that they so both teams have gone to the locker room, and I suspect that they will confer with the officials, perhaps the league, and make a decision on where we go as far as the first period. But obviously our concerns and our thoughts are with Jay Bouwmeester. And we'll keep the situation monitored here. And again, we'll tell you as soon as we know. For the moment, we go back to our studio in St. Louis and Scott Warman.
If you could read lips, the guy's talking, he was not talking. It kind of just looked like he fell off the bench there. So what happened, we're not sure. But, I mean, you could see the medical personnel got there very quickly. Ray Burilli was there quickly. He saw the stretcher going across when we came back from the break. So everybody was there. And it looked like there was a little relief from the players as they were talking. They were, of course, everybody was concerned. But it looked like there must have been some movement and stuff that the guys relaxed a little bit when they all started clapping when they took the stretcher down the hallway. Or the hallway towards the locker room. So we'll keep you posted as quickly as we get the information. But you hate to see situations like this. I mean, I think we can go back. We talked about Chris Pronger, the slap shot that he took in the chest. Yes. There. It goes back to Detroit a few years ago. Yeah. That's one of the things I do remember. And I think everybody was really concerned. No one really knew exactly what happened. I mean, I've been involved. I mean, you go back to Clint Malarchuk with the skate cut there across his neck going back to Buffalo a number of years ago. Don Luce goes back to my second year I was playing in Buffalo where he got a skate across the face. It was a lot of scary moments going on with this, but
absolutely. You saw his
moment in any sport when you see something like this.
Yeah, happen. There's a shot on Thursday, 1-0
twice.
And he switched.
This game is going to progress and what's
right.
Going to happen.
So if you're just tuning in, just to let you again know that we're in a delay situation. Here's a last sequence of play before we had the under 10 break. And there's Jay Bouwmeester who got the clear out pass. And then he switches off with Carl Gunnarsson. And then you'll see this is actually during the break is the rollout with John. And you see Jay Bouwmeester basically falling down. And you saw Vince Dunn right behind him just waving. And then you'll see the Blues captain, Alex Pietrangelo, waving as many medical people. And they were quick on the draw to get over to the Blues bench area and then work on the Blues player there. And then eventually, as we mentioned, if you didn't see it, they did take Jay Bouwmeester off on a stretcher into the Blues locker room. And both teams are in the locker again as we're under 10 minutes that have been played, over 10 minutes played at the Honda Center. And the two teams are tied at one apiece, Bernie.
Yeah, and we can only go back so far in that replay because he wasn't obviously ISO'd on the play. But it didn't look like Bouwmeester had been hit in the corner right. Or anything had happened. It just looked like he had made the pass up and then skated off the ice. Now, what happened after that, we don't know at all. And as we keep saying, is that our thoughts and prayers are right now that nothing is serious. And we did see the stretcher. Anytime you see a stretcher come on the ice and you can see the concern on the faces of the players, that's when you always get a little concerned.
And here's the thing also, Bernie, and you know this very well. Obviously, you played the game at the highest level. We know what great condition all of these professional athletes are, no matter what sport, but even hockey as well. But Jay Bouwmeester, even at the age of 36, is one of the most well-conditioned guys on this hockey team.
Absolutely. And that's why I say we can't really even speculate on anything at all. I mean, every one of those guys out there is in such great physical condition. We really didn't see what happened anywhere. I mean, maybe there was something, an incident that happened half a minute earlier sure. that may have led to something. But I certainly don't know, I don't even want to think about anything bad. I'm just hoping that everything is good right now. It was just a little tweak of something that happened. And in the next few minutes, we'll hear word, and hopefully everything is going to be 100%.
So we roll it back once again. And here is the last shift that Jay Bouwmeester had before he went to the bench area as, again, the Blues cycling the puck down low with the Bozak, Steen, and Thomas line. And there is the transition by the Anaheim Ducks. Colton Parayko, Jay Bouwmeester getting back on defense. And the puck would get back into the neutral zone area. And again, just a chip in, and just doesn't seem right up to this point, Bernie, that there's really any physical contact.
Right. I mean, there's still the only contact there, Scotty,
a
right
rub
there.
On
it's
the
not even rough contact here. Let's see if we can stay with this. And he is heading, no, because he stayed out in the ice there. There he is again. And I think this is just a little reverse. That's a little
reverse,
and he ends up coming out with a puck very shortly. This may be the play here, the last play we saw. Yeah, here it is here. So really, we
just
didn't
that
see
little
any
rub
physical
behind the
play.
Net.
Yeah. So I really don't know. I mean, this is really strange right now, and We're just going to have to wait like everybody else for the word when we get it. And that's the frustrating part of something like this. When you see something like that happen, there's no explanation. And when we don't know what happened or what is happening, I think that's what makes it even more frustrating.
And